Hey everybody! No, I'm not a Jedi, just Dr. Patrick from Scotlea Hot Rods. Here with our latest creation, the X-34 Landspeeder from Star Wars. It's out of this world. Hey everybody, welcome back to Scotlea Hot Rods. I'm Dr. Patrick, and this is our X-34 Landspeeder from the very first Star Wars movie. Yes, this is what Luke Skywalker drove around the world of Tatooine. This is what Obi-Wan Kenobi rode in. C-3PO and R2-D2 even rode on this. This is an iconic machine. Now, how did we build this? Well, really simply, we got a hold of a body made off the original molds. So this is exact. This is the right dimensions, the right sizes, everything. Just as it was in the movie. Now, we had to build everything other than just the fiberglass body, and we'll show you how we did that in a little bit. But first, let's take a tour around this beast, show you some of the details. All right, so here we go. Now, starting off with, this is actually a pretty big vehicle. It's approximately 13 foot long. It's 8.5 feet wide from engine to engine. So to put this in an enclosed trailer, it has to be disassembled a little bit. Now, it's got all the damage and scorch marks like you would see. And we did a video on how we painted this, so check that out as well. But this is the real deal. It is a blast to drive. And talk about turning heads. Nothing does it better than this. So let's look at some of the inside stuff here. Well, we've got 3 engine pods mounted to the body. Now in the movie, this is a repulsor lift that lifted, and the turbines in the back just gave it propulsion to move forward. We've replicated all that right down to the exposed and burnt up engine, showing all the internal mechanisms and work, and really me even made it all scorched and burnt like. On the back, there are a pair of engine pods. We're not sure what these are supposed to do, just some sort of probably has to do with the repulsor lift mechanisms, but copies as close as we could get to the originals off of lots of pictures. Moving on to the interior, seating for 2. Yes, it is pretty tight. We do have to remove the steering wheel to get in and out. We have a pair of dash pods that are actually forward and rear view cameras. All our controls on the dash, and I'll show you in a minute what all that does. All the exposed wiring components on the hood. Some of that is actually functional. A lot of it's just for show. The grills down the sides. The damage that really wasn't ever explained what it came from on the front. And on the side there as well. Lots of scorch, burned, sandblasted from driving around a desert world. This was just a lot of fun. And we're going to show you some details in a moment of underneath and how we run this thing. But does it run? Yes, it does. 35 miles an hour. And it's riding on airbags, so it's actually a pretty comfy ride. We can raise it up to go over any obstacles or drop it down low for cruising. It's a lot like a car. Let's take a little ride.
All right, can't go around the galaxy, but we can go around the neighborhood.
Chased by a dog.
Uh-oh, pedestrian. But he has no idea we're just passing.
Showing you, so I can turn on the scanner. The engines light up just like they're hot from all the exhaust, and they have fans built into them, so there's actually air blowing out of the back of each of them, so if you walk behind it you feel a little bit of thrust. And I can control the speed and thus the volume. Down the engines, and control it all from right here. Okay, here we are back in the shop, and we're going to take a look at what makes this thing work. Now, there's no hood, there's no trunk, it's really too low to get underneath it and work on it. We had to devise a way to be able to get this body on and off to access everything underneath it. Now, we built a couple of these in the past, and then we just took a couple of guys, lifted the body up, stuck a prop right underneath it so we could hold it in place. It was always a little bit sketchy. Didn't know if it was going to fall and decapitate you at any minute. So we wanted to be a little bit easier on us this time. So we used a little pair of 600-pound linear actuators. And all I got to do is push a button. Takes about 60 seconds. The body's hinged on the back. It raises right up and gives us complete access to everything we need. It's solid and secure and safe, so we can get to work. So we'll let this rise up, and then we'll take a look at what's going on underneath.
All right, so now we're going to take a look underneath this thing and see what's going on. Now, the heart of this entire system is this Uno battery and the battery charger that's connected to it there on the right. This is a 58-volt lithium battery. It's one battery. That's the entire thing right there. 58 volts, it'll run for hours. So no worries. These are used to replace golf carts batteries when you have a six or a four battery setup. This makes them double their speed. So far we've gotten this thing up to 35 miles per hour. It is fast. Now within that, we've got a lot of electronics going on. So here on the right, you've got that green controller that runs the motor and a couple of power inverters and a solenoid. Since this is 58 volts and a lot of the electronics are 12 volt, we have to step down power and make sure we don't fry anything while we're playing with all our toys. In the back there, you see the motor on the engine there. That's a 4,000 kilowatt motor. It's mounted to a regular easy go golf cart axle that's been narrowed to be able to fit this, and supported by a pair of airbags, one on each side, with a three link rear end system to locate it nice and steady. Up front, we again took a golf cart front suspension and heavily modified it. First, we had to narrow it quite a bit. This is only about 2.5 feet wide. The whole frame itself, it's just over 3 feet wide.
Again, on a pair of airbags. So we've got four airbags, one on each corner, so it gives it nice and secure, and able to adjust for weight and bias. Our steering system is a little different because this is right-hand drive. So the steering has to go over to what would normally be the passenger side. That's easily done with a couple of U-joints. And then it's propped up and held in place securely. And then this whole system right here is our RideTech Ride Pro system. An air tank lets us raise and lower the body. It normally sits about 2 inches off the ground. We can drive with it about 4 inches off the ground pretty easily. Raise it up to about 6 to 8 inches to go over speed bumps and such. And that whole system allows us to do that with just a touch of a button. Pedal assembly is straight out of a golf cart. Throttle, brake, and a parking brake, or what they call a hill brake on a golf cart. All going on there. Again, a lot more wiring and electronics than you would see normally in a golf cart. We've got a 6-outlet fuse relay panel. The box up on the top controls our linear actuators. That silver box in the middle there controls our engine fans. Lots of wires. Lots of things going on. Now, if you're wondering how we made that little scanner work up on the hood, well, here you go. It's a universal window mechanism, just mounted flat to the body with the scanner poked down through and attached to it. Spins it round and round at a decent speed pretty easily. Very simple system. Here you can see the two linear actuators mounted to the body and the frame. It's not really complex. It works real well. It is compact. 2 6-foot tall people can fit in this. It's not comfortable. You wouldn't want to be in there for a long period of time, but it's just the right amount of space. There's not a lot of room to move things around here, so everything had to be very tightly packaged to get it all to fit. So that's what makes this thing tick. Running off that Uno battery, Navitas engine controller and motor system. Again, it's pushed this thing to about 35 miles an hour so far, as you saw earlier when I was driving it. You're really cooking along. All right, let's go into the cockpit and take a look around in there. Okay, so here we are down in the cockpit. Say it's a pretty tight fit. You have to take the steering wheel off to get in and out, but it's a quick release. Goes on and off pretty easy. Lots of controls and switches happening in here. First of all, up here on the cockpit, these little pods, rear view camera, front view camera, they do record, so if you wanted to record driving around at a parade or something, you could do that. Control panel here, switches for our air ride controls, which are here inside this little hidden box, so we can raise and lower the vehicle however we like, and just hide that control because it looks a little too modern. Okay. We have a switch here that runs our air compressor. Should we need to put more air in the tank? This switch turns on our cameras. We have a switch that runs a scanner out on the hood, spins that around. This is just a main power switch. Then we have the switch that turns on the engine lights, turns on the engine fans, and then a knob for controlling the engine speed. So everything here actually has a purpose. We can run it off from that. We can also raise and lower the body from in here if you don't want to use the remote. Another pair of toggle switches here that activate the engine drive system, and then a front, forward and reverse switch. This doesn't really do anything. It was in the movie, so we put it in here, but it's not connected to anything. But it's fun to act like you're going fast, you're going slow, when you're actually running it with the pedals with your feet. But you can pretend you're speeding up, slowing down, however you like. Like I said, it's a tight fit. You do kind of have to squeeze in here, but it's like getting in and out of a kayak. So it's not too bad. My feet are on the pedals. I'm just over 6 foot tall, so this is, I built it to fit me perfectly. A shorter person would have a lot easier time fitting in here and working everything. But everything, we're here right in one hand, you can get to everything. You can ride with both arms inside. It is a little bit more cramped. Okay, but so having one arm outside the windshield does help a little bit. But that's how you control this thing. So if we wanted to go, flip our power switches on, forward, and then hit the drive, and we take off. Back up, flip the switch, backs it up. Pretty simple. Power down, just like that. Okay, another one of the cool features we added onto this Landspeeder is the ability to control some of the functions via Wi-Fi from an app on our phone. So we've got this set up for two things. One, I can hit a button and on come the lights and the scanner. And even better, hit this next button. The entire theme song. It's a little over 5 minutes long, so we won't do that whole thing, but it's fun. It just kind of gives you another toy you can play with, be able to control this. So go to a car show, can sit back and people walk up, play the music. Things you can do with electronics nowadays. And all of that is actually located here in the exposed electronics that in the movie were the result of a missing hatch. Most of that is fake, but we did hide the little Wi-Fi relay down in there. So the antenna is very active on top of it. Gives us good range and the ability to do neat little things like that. So just another fun feature.